वेलकम बैक टू आवर चैनल ट्रिपल का ट्रैवल।
सो मोस्ट ऑफ यू गाइस हैज बीन मैसेजिंग अस ऑन इंस्टाग्राम अबाउट व्हाट इज योर एक्सपीरियंस इन जॉर्जिया एंड अबाउट द यूनिवर्सिटी। सो इन दिस वीडियो वी आर प्लानिंग टू क्लियर ऑल योर डाउट्स एंड ऑल योर क्वेश्चंस एज फार वी नो एंड या
सो लेट्स स्टार्ट द वीडियो विदाउट एनी डिले। So first I am gonna tell about my experience, like how I met these guys and all. And first I met like most of our SU students who are coming here in the visa office while like applying for visa. But I didn't see her. I saw her, but I was not considering her as my classmate because someone told me she's a transfer student. So I thought she's a somewhat experienced than us, so I didn't consider as my classmate, and I thought there are only two girls who are going to SU, and I was little tense and like, what's gonna happen after going there? I don't know anyone like that, because I came from another place and these are all from some Hyderabad and I'm from Andhra Pradesh, so I thought there would be something gonna be hectic for me.
I'm not afraid to go to Georgia because I'm a transfer student and this is not my first time. So basically first when I met Priya in the visa office, she was very nervous and she was in a hurry because some mistake was there in her form. So she was very tense. So I thought to interact with her and make her calm. There is no problem for that. So she was she wasn't distracted and she was very conscious with her problem and she wasn't replying properly. Then I thought okay, she's starting.
Actually I was like busy with that and I was like there is some problem with the signature and that thing. So I came from some other place, so I can't go there and do that, solve that. So I'm thinking that.
So at that time I have been judgmental towards her as she is a little negligent type of girl.
Egoist.
Not egoist. I can't say with one meeting everything, na. So she is little negligent and also a serene kind of girl. So I take my words back to Priya now.
So coming to my experience, so because of few problems I didn't went to the visa office on the day which all the SU students
which
went.
We didn't meet her.
So I just went on the next day with the another university. So I thought I am the only one student who is going to the SU university. So at that time I thought, should I change the university or should I join in this SU university, because I thought I am the only one girl and I just met all of these fellows in the airport only. So
yeah, we first saw her in the airport and we just introduced there itself. We came to know her there itself.
Yeah. So we got to know each other on that traveling only.
A little bit more.
And also there was a huge gap in the transit. So there was a lot of time in the transit for us to
nearly
interact with each other.
10 hours,
around
right?
10 to 12 hours, I guess. I don't know.
But however, we talked with each other and we passed the time and we finally went to Georgia.
Yes.
So initially when we didn't come here, I thought that we can manage here with English, like we can manage with English, but no, actually we should learn Georgian first. When we came here, everyone are talking in Georgian and we were blanked out, like what's going on, what they are talking. Now we are managing and we can understand, and you will also learn by slowly, like in university also they will make you learn, we'll be having that you Georgian classes, so we learn, and that's all like language. I felt this and about
and before coming we thought we would face any problem, we would face problem regarding the accent and all, the teaching pattern and all. So it wasn't any problem because
lecturers can speak good English and in university we will be not facing any problems with our language. But when we
go out, the language problem comes when we go out.
Wherever we go, like any bank, any food, everything. We need some basic Georgian language as well, that is local language.
Because they don't know a little
English,
bit of English also, like
it's
here.
A bit difficult.
Mm.
So it's recommended to learn
Georgian
language a bit at least.
Yeah.
Basic normal using words and all.
After coming here, you can learn.
Yeah. It's not that hard. You can learn it easily.
She's telling lies. It was hard. I should say that up to now we are crossing 2 years, but we know only basic
words. Only basic
words. But we can manage.
Yeah, we can manage.
And then next about
it is hard because we are least interested to
learn the language.
If you have interest, it's very easy.
It's very easy, yeah.
So coming to the girl safety thing, so many of the people have the
parents.
So many of the parents have doubts regarding girl safety when we are sending a girl to the foreign country and all. But that is no problem, literally I'm saying you, because as we know in India, we have seen many cases regarding the girl safety. But here, there is no problem to worry at all.
It's the safest country.
It's the safest country, I can say.
Yes.
We can roam around 10:30 as well. Because no one will care.
Basically, here government is very strict. Like if there is a problem for one girl, a normal citizen also, they will take a strict reactions. So I think it's really good in that way.
Yeah.
So we can be so strong, and you can send your daughters as well.
Yes, it's a really safest country for all the girls and the boys. So. So in India, we'll get a lot of vegetables to eat, and I expected we'll get same vegetables in this Georgian country also, but we'll get only the basic vegetables here, and we can manage with that because we are moving from our native place to some other place, right? So yeah,
foreign means you can't expect
that much. So coming to the restaurants, here there are a lot of Indian restaurants, but there is not that good taste as compared to India. And also, okay, we can adjust with that food also.
But we can make our food if we stay out.
If we stay out. And okay, we can also eat the Georgian food also here. It's also
some food we can eat here.
Like kachapuri and all, lobiani. So it's good only. So there is no
problem.
But initially we thought we will get good food, but we can say that we can't get that much good.
Initially we thought it would be a problem, but it's okay.
Yeah, we can manage with that food. You have to adjust in any
of
way.
Of course.
Yeah.
Even we move from our native place to one small hostel also, we should
adjust
for food. We won't get the same food which we get in our house.
Yeah.
So we are coming to foreign, we should adjust.
Coming to the university, so first when we thought, first we saw the university, it was like a five-star hotel.
I was like,
it was really, really good.
Yeah, it was really good and
huge.
Like we have two blogs, one is old blog and one is new blog, and new blog is like five-star hotel. Like it's
you
awesome.
Have you, most of you would be
seen
in our previous vlog at college too.
But directly if you see me, it's really good.
It's
really
good.
Yeah. It was so good. It was so huge, maybe because like we will be not having like medical separate. We'll be having combined, like all other courses will be attached in the same one. So
like engineering, BBA, management courses, all
many
be also there in our university.
And we also have a canteen lobby and also some labs like anatomy lab and histology
and also
labs.
Library and the basic things which are there in the college, all are there in that. Basically in the library we have computers rather than many books because as we know foreign is basically of e-learning. So everything is available on the computer.
So when we both went to the library, so I just saw only one anatomy book in the library and I was just shocked, like what's happening.
We asked her who is the library head. We asked her like only one anatomy book and she's like, you see in computer. What's the big deal? She was
like,
but we are habituated to books now.
So in India, everyone have these many books, many more books who are studying medicine.
Especially MBBS.
MBBS.
Everyone will be having these much big books. But here we'll be having one laptop
and
one
phone.
That's it. Everything will be in that and we should manage. Initially, we felt like we can't learn in the laptops, but we were
habituated to that.
So our books are totally in phones and laptops. So we also got habituated for the e-learning.
Before that, we thought we can have books, but no books.
No
only books. E-learning. And also timing. We faced
Basically in India we have a scheduled time, so from morning 9 o'clock to evening mm-hmm. six
five,
or
six.
Seven it will be there like that. So here now it's different from day to day in a week. So and also about the classes, if we have, for example, Monday we have anatomy, so the next class will be on the next week Monday. And in this 1 week you need to prepare the seminar on it and present, and you'll have the marks on it.
So initially we thought we can give seminars later, but you people don't do that mistake. For every class you need to give the seminar, because each and every marks are counted and it's added in the final exam. So each seminar it's approximately 3 marks.
3 marks.
Daily
seminar.
In each lecture we have to present the previous lecture seminar, and we'll get 3 marks.
And it will be oral, by the way. And basically the main difference regarding the study pattern is that in India we'll have region wise study. And here it will be like system-wise study. So in India, if you think, if you take
hand, we'll count it like
muscles, nerves, ligaments, innervation and all, nerve supply and everything. So here it will be like if you take a muscle system, like muscular
system. First we'll complete skeletal system.
All the muscles,
muscular system.
Skeletal system, all the skeleton, all the bones.
All the muscles, all the nerves, and
all the nervous system means all the nerves in the body.
Yeah,
like that.
And I especially expected like cadavers and like we will be like, when before joining MBBS we will be having that dream like to dissect a cadaver and like that. But we won't experience that in this foreign, like
because
in our university we didn't we can't experience that.
We have only
the artificial
bodies here, so we can do anything with that artificial bodies.
But not
so
like
we
live
can't
one.
Experience live.
Live,
but hoping so after in final years we may experience.
Can't experience. No cadavers will be available.
Oh, not in the
cadavers.
I mean,
but
to say when we join to hospital.
Patients.
Direct attack.
And
but don't worry, we will be not appointed directly as a doctor, but it will be stages as a nurse, as a junior doctor, and then doctor.
We used to live in hostel, and then after we went to India, and then we came back and we shifted to apartments. This is just like why we wanted to shift from hostel means like we are wasting a lot of money. That's the main thing. Like in hostel means we'll be having a certain pattern of keeping food. Like Monday means we'll be having that only. Every Monday that only. But we got bored of that after eating for 1 month. We got bored.
Like they're having craving to get the new type of
food
and we were investing our pocket money totally on food only.
Like we are paying money to the hostel, and also in the other hand we are just wasting the money on the food. So we just thought, why can't we move to the apartment and why can't we cook
just
food to ourselves
once.
So
we want to experience this feeling as well, like making
food
by ourselves, cleaning, washing
everything.
So we came out like it's about 6 to 7 months.
Eight months.
Now we are happy.
Living independent,
so
doing our own work.
Is that as it is online now, we don't have any problem to cook food and cleaning and all. So if the classes start for offline, if the classes start in the college, now we can't tell you because It may become problem, but there is no problem for the food. Like you can also
order
student menu.
We can also
for the different restaurants.
There will be many Indian restaurants which give us like student menu, like per month $100 for two times a day.
$90 to $100.
So there is no problem in this food. So we can manage it.
He just came out to just experiment once and see. Is it working out or not?
Can we manage?
Can we manage
studies,
or not?
Along with studies, these can we
cooking,
manage?
Like
household
things.
Like that. I think we can manage.
Yes, we can manage it.
We are proud of ourselves.
Yes, proud.
So this is all about how we moved.
And
how
do we leave now? We leave the next station from the where college is there. One station. We already told you, I think, like we can move in 5 minutes.
The answer is yes, obviously you can do if language is not the barrier means.
Yeah. You can work anywhere if you know the perfect language.
Not English, local language, which is Georgian, which we also
don't know.
That's why as this is not the English speaking country, we need to know a basic language in Georgian to work anywhere.
Yeah.
So
We should understand and we should be able to interact
with them.
So we thought of working in the hospitals, but there are few exams which is conducted only in the Georgian language instead of the English. So we don't know that much Georgian language. We know only the basic words.
Yeah, we have to understand the questions and write it in
Georgian
language,
which is difficult.
And if we pass, I think it would be in oral also, I guess, maybe. Oral means we'll go blank.
We don't know that much fluent Georgian language, right? So that's the reason we just dropped it.
And part-time job, up to now, we didn't do any part-time jobs. So we didn't earn any money from here. We are just
planning for it. So hope.
Let's see. If we work anywhere, we will let you know.
So if you have any doubts regarding the college or hostel, anything, just comment in the comment section. So we'll just try to answer all of them.
Yeah. If you want to know more about us also, you can ask us. If you have any questions, you can ask us. We will try to answer it.
Or else DM us in the Instagram, which is in the description. Yeah. And this is all about this video.
Our experience in Georgia.
So hope this video is helpful for you before traveling to Georgia.
If anyone are traveling here, it will be useful. Yeah, and if some are like, if you want to know what we are doing in Georgia, then also it will be useful. And so that's it for today. And if you like this video,
please do like, share, comment,
and
also subscribe
to our channel Triple Cut Travel.
And also don't forget to ring the bell icon. And see you in the next vlog.
Yes, bye.